I'm going to go through exercises on data types. First, let's write a program to interchange the first and last constituent in a list. Let's compute the length of the list and interchange the first constituent with the n-1th constituent. Since index starts from 0 in Python, the last constituent would be represented by index n-1. LTH is the length of the list LT. Let's interchange the first and the n-1th element. We define a new variable op to be equal to the first element, and then the first element is made the same as the last element. So the last element would be equal to op. Let's print list1 after passing it through the function change. As you can see, the first and the last element in list1 have been exchanged. Second, let's write a program to interchange any two elements in a list. The method is to use the inbuilt functions in Python and insert. We are defining the function change, which takes three arguments: list LT, position P1, and position P2. In the first statement, here we are removing the element in position P1, and in the second statement, we are removing the element in position P2. Since index starts from 0 in Python, the position P2 would be represented by index P2 minus 1. The path function removes the constituent from the list LT and returns back the value. The insert function puts back the constituent in new positions. Now we use the return statement to see the final list obtained. We'll define the arguments now. L is the list in index for P1 and P2 would be 0 and 3 respectively. Let's see the list L after executing change function. 8, 6, 7, 5, 9 is the resultant list obtained after executing the change function. As you can see, the first and the fourth element have exchanged their positions. Third, let's write a program to find the maximum of two numbers using the max function. The max function finds the element having the greatest value. M is the maximum of values A and B, which is 10. Fourth, let's write a program to find the minimum of two numbers using the min function. The min function finds the element having the smallest value. N is the minimum of values A and B, which is 1. Fifth, let's write a program to clear a list using the clear method. Here we are defining list A. Let's print the value of list A before clearing it. The syntax for clearing the list using the inbuilt clear method is list name dot clear. Let's print the value of list A after clearing it. Sixth, let's write a program to check whether an element exists in a list. We can use a for loop that iterates through all elements to confirm the presence of an element. We have defined list B here. Let's use a for loop to check the presence of the element, say 90. Let's check whether 90 is present in the list or not using loop. It gives a message element is present as 90 is present in the list. N is the most typical method to confirm whether an element is present in a list. Let's use the IN method to check the presence of 90 in list B. Here we have got the same message that element is present in the list using the IN method as well. Seventh, let's write a program to count the number of times an element occurs in a list. One method is to use for loop. Here we are using a for loop to move through each element in the list and confirm whether it is equal to y, and keeping a count on the occurrences of the element in such a way that it gives out the final count when we execute the function. We have defined the arguments list underscore c and y. Let's check the number of times the element 10 occurs using loop. It gives a message 10 is present 4 times. So as we can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is correct. The format method provides a formatting to the values based on the codes within placeholders. The placeholder is identified by curly brackets in the string and the parameters are inserted there. By default, placeholders can be used without any format code as it is in this example. Another way is to utilize count method. Count the times an element occurs in the list. We have defined a function times which takes in arguments list and y. It counts the number of times an element y occurs in the list using the count method. Let's check the number of times the element y occurs using the count method. 10 has occurred 4 times. We've got the count of element 10 here using count method, and this is true as well, just like we did before. 8th, let's write a program to compute sum and average of list. Sum function computes the total of all elements in a data object and start. The syntax of sum function is sum iterable sum. Here start is 0, s is equal to sum list d, that is to compute the sum of all the elements in list d. Let's check out the value of s. 52 is the sum of list d. Start parameter is equal to 20. S is the sum of list d and 20. Let's check the value of s now. It's 72. We can compute the average using sum and len functions. Sum function gives the total of all constants. Len function gives the length of a list, that is the count of elements in a list. We've created a function f taking in the argument list. It is computing the average of a list by dividing sum by length of the list. We have defined list c here. Av is the average of list c using the av function. Let's check the value of av, the average. The round function rounds off a number to the given number of digits. Syntax of round function is round number of digits. Let's check the average. Average of list is 96.1. Ninth, let's write a program to get all even numbers in a list. Here, the for loop iterates through each element in the list and checks whether the element is completely divisible by 2 or not, and prints out only the element if this condition is satisfied. This will extract all the even numbers in the list. Let's check out the even numbers. As you can clearly see, 89, which seems to be an odd number, has been excluded here. This seems to be correct. 10th, let's write programs to get all odd numbers in a list. One method is to use a for loop to iterate through the constants and confirm whether k modulus 2 is not equal to 0. The for loop checks whether an element, say k, is not completely divisible by 2. This would suggest that it is an odd number. So we'll extract all the elements which do satisfy this condition. 89 is the result here, and since most of the numbers in the list are even, it seems to be correct.